When the water-holding capacity of the soil itself is raised, there's much less need to store water in impoundments and much less water running off of the soil. Soil is made to be more of a water-retaining sponge by increasing the amount of organic matter, air pore space, and the depth of the root zone, or rhizosphere. One early step in drought-proofing agricultural landscapes is by improving the tilth of the soil. P.A. Yeomans was very aware of this and even developed implements and a specific soil cultivation pattern in order to rapidly improve the water and nutrient-holding capacities of soil. This is the Yeomans plow he developed, adapted from a chisel plow in 1952, improved throughout the years, and used by many to this day. The cultivation pattern of the plowing is to slope the furrows from valleys down to the ridges so water gently drifts towards the drier parts of the terrain, creating equal water absorption over the whole landscape, which increases the overall water-holding capacity by saturating the normally drier ridges. This pattern is referred to as the keyline cultivation pattern geometry. And here's Darren Dougherty speaking about the keyline plow and its applications.
So if I just run a keyline plow through this once to 12 inches of depth, then that'll immediately absorb 2 inches of rainfall. Right? Because so that means I have to get 2 and a bit inches of rainfall before I get any runoff now. You know what I'm saying? Get run through if you've got impermeable substratas, but if you've got plant life living on top of that, which are transpiring, you're not going to get a lot of runoff.